I'm Sofiah Thom, and I want to invite you to come and check out this amazing interview I just did with Laura Hollick up north here in Costa Rica. We had just come out of the ocean after being mermaids, and we were really rather wet. So we ended up using this new mic that we have. With this new mic, you definitely feel like you're immersed in the waves. So I want to invite you to wear headphones if you can, so you can really hear the amazing content of the dialogue that we had, as well as feeling like you're immersed in Costa Rica, beautiful beach. So enjoy. Thank you.
Okay.
Hello, I'm here with Laura Hollick, one of my muses and inspirers. You may have seen that I was just with Laura in her beautiful studio in Toronto doing her new icon movie intensive. Laura is a creator, an artist of life, of art, of business, and I'm excited to be here with you. As you can see, we just came out of the ocean. We had an incredible mermaid experience together this morning. Mm-hmm. And I'm honored to have Laura here in our magical paradise. So welcome, Laura.
Thank you. I love Costa Rica, so beautiful. Mm. Yep.
Good. And Costa Rica loves you. Yeah. So I'm so inspired to share your mission and vision and how you live so aptly today, and I would love for you to share, you know, really on the theme of living your yes, which you really created such a beautiful creative life for yourself, and the way that you have orchestrated your creations to support your creative process and other people's creative process. So I'd love for you to share a little bit about that creation.
I think it goes way back to when I was a kid and I used to just imagine worlds. I'd go out, kind of, I didn't live on the ocean, but I'd go out to whatever nature we had around us, and I would just sit and I would see whole realities, and I would come up with ideas for clothing and, you know, what kind of food. And I would go to my mom, I'm like, Mom, can I get a dress like this? And I'm like, that doesn't exist. And she would get really frustrated with me because we could never shop together because all the things I envisioned, they didn't exist. And I realized that if I wanted the things that I imagined, I had to create them. And so then I just did that. I just started creating things. I made my own clothes. I made my own events. I made, like, even as a kid, I would do little plays. And then it turned into business. I'm like, oh, I want to make money. What can I do that? And I would imagine what my life would be like and how can I create that? So it just goes back to this idea of I would imagine worlds and they didn't exist for me at that time. And I would make them real. I would find a way to make it real.
Mm, gorgeous. Yeah, I mean, you invited me to come up, you know, with a handful of incredible women to create the new icon movie intensive. I mean, for me, you know, it was such a beautiful experience that I really felt like I received this, you know, this experience of the temple body pieces coming through me, and you know, this came through by embodying a color, color orange. And you know, how did that even come to be? And you know, I'd love to just hear about that.
Oh my gosh, where do I start? Okay, so because the colors. So the new icon movie, which is what you're a part of. That, again, it was a vision. And it actually happened in Colombia, South America, on a beach just like this. And I was walking along and I had a vision of a rainbow bird woman. And she was walking towards me. And I mean, it was imagination, but I felt the reality of it, almost like a future reality of it. And I was like, well, like, who are you? What, why am I seeing this? And she just showed me her rainbow. Mm. And I was like, oh my gosh, there's something about the rainbow. And I realized that the colors in the rainbow represented people and all different types of very unique, creative people. And as they were in their vibration of their color, that brought together the power for the wings of this woman to fly. And so I just started this project, New Icon, where I would bring together different people to represent colors, to bring out their most potent medicine, and then do that in a group, and the energetics are so that this rainbow bird woman could fly. As all of us are doing our thing, it empowers the energy of that archetype. And I don't even fully understand it, but it feels like such a heart connection that it's almost like a higher self guide. So that's how that came to be.
Beautiful. I love that, you know, by us coming to you and you taking us on this journey to really experience our iconic essence, that then we can go out into the world and share from that place as well. And I feel like our life and our life art is very parallel. And you know, for me, what came to me was, like I said, this temple body priestess that's really ready to come forward and to initiate. And to initiate others into their own temple body, to wake up to their temple body and to their womb with them. You know, it's so interesting because I'm now preparing to bear this temple body initiation for this small group of women, you know, online, and I'm doing it the same day that the movie's coming out.
I know, and you didn't know, and it's just, see, that's like the magic.
Right.
And I feel like when we tune into like the deeper calling, that's what happens, and you can't even contrive how brilliant it can be, but it requires so much trust to drop into that place of listening and then letting that magic move through. And so you totally do that, and you know, all the women in that project do that, and I feel like that's my spiritual practice, is to exercise the ability to do that, to listen deep and then take the action that it's asking me to take. And it's usually a stretch. It's usually something that's a little bit like out of my comfort zone, and so it feels like a workout spiritually to do that. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I feel so strong. I've been feeling that. It's like when you step into new levels of yourself and of business or healing, it's like it literally feels like you're stretching beyond your limit.
Absolutely.
And yet there's this place where we're, I know I like to call it like dancing your edge, where you're in the edge and you're like, okay, you know, there's, you have to give us permission to actually stretch beyond what we already know. And I mean, that's going into that space of, okay, I'm imagining, I'm seeing, I'm visualizing, I know that it's possible. It's about believing.
Yes. And then there's the death too, like that stretch, it cracks the edge of whatever shell was the previous. And it's not even a shell meaning that you're like tucked away somewhere, it's just the edge, and it feels like a shell. So you're like letting that go to be able to birth the next creation. And so there's often grieving too, like the ability to be with the letting go and the dying, to be able to be with the birth. And that's a workout too. Because oftentimes like that, we want to hold on to what we understand in place of entering a reality that is the dream, but there's no proof yet to it. So yeah, it's a journey for sure. And it is, I would say, totally my spiritual practice is doing that, is creating, is being, I almost like a giant womb. I think I'm a giant womb. A giant, like, not physically, but like a giant womb of like ideas and birthing them, and even holding space for other people's creations to pass through the portal from imagination to reality. Yeah. So it's amazing to hear that that's happening for you. That is in the heart of what my essence is creating that for myself and creating space for others to birth their dreams in reality.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
And it also feels like, you know, one thing that I really teach is about how we have to align with the frequency of yes. We have to really, and that is that space of like believing and seeing and not allowing ourselves to go into something of fear or doubt. And, you know, can you speak around the process for you, and I feel like it's connected to death, like having to literally let go of maybe people or situations in order to step into your fullest potential.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is the permission to self, saying I'm willing to let myself have a bigger vision of what's possible. And so yeah, then there's things that we let go of, like letting go of the fear that, oh, I can't be successful, or oh, I can't make money doing this because I've never seen it happen. And there's fear to it, but there's the death. I feel that, I definitely feel fear. I absolutely do, and I can be in full on like terrified of something. But I guess the thing that carries me through is that my dream is bigger. Like I just feel the love of my vision, and it wraps its arms around that fear. So I can be in my like, oh my gosh, I don't know what's going on, and totally in a state of that. But all I need is one little clue, one glimmer to remind me of the vision, and I'm reminded that there's something bigger holding me. Like it could even be, I see a feather on my path. I'm like, oh right, yes, Rainbow Bird Woman. She's, you know, so for me, the fear is totally there, but the vision is bigger. So I have something that holds me, and it carries me to take the step that I'm afraid of. And you know, if I say I'm going on stage, like when I did my TED talk, I was terrified. I was thinking, I hope this place burns down. I don't have to go out there and do this. And I was behind the stage. I'm like, okay, fire alarm, you're okay to go off anytime. And then they called me out, and I just smiled and I went out there, and it's like I could feel like I was held, but the fear is there. I think that's the piece. It's like if we know it's going to be there, we don't expect it's not, because I've never expanded and not felt fear. I can't think of a time when I consciously chose to expand and I didn't feel a nervousness. But now that I've been doing it so much, I know it's there, and I can enter it. Mm. I have permission to go anyways. I feel like every time there's an expansion, the body has to get this upgrade in the cells, the neural networks, and like how do the bones relate to this new idea? And I feel like that's your expertise, really. And you know, it's something that I'm exploring, but I actually feel like that's like one of your iconic essence qualities, is the ability to let the body be that bridge from the inner world of the imagination and the vision, and then actually having the embodiment to support the reality. I would love to hear anything you have to say on that, because I think that that's so important. And all of us, when we're in that creative mode, we all have to face that ability to embody the vision.
Mm. Yeah, I love how you posed that, because, you know, in my background of dance therapy, it's really, fundamentally, it's about creating new pathways of moving. When we create new pathways of moving in our body and in the way that we move and dance and walk through as well, we actually create new pathways of moving, you know, within our thoughts and beliefs and how we act in the world. So it's creating pathways, which, you know, a lot of people speak about in the way that we have thought forms and thought patterns, like reprogramming. Mm-hmm. It's ultimately like we have to reprogram our DNA, yeah, through that, you know, how we hold ourselves and the essence that of who we are, how it should, you know, can translate through the body. And so the body is the inner landscape and outer landscape. And so really it's through the embodiment practices, you know, that I teach, and through breathwork, and actually it's kind of creating more space and emptying out, because we tend to just take on all this stuff and energy and stuff that's not ours, and, you know, getting stuck in these old patterns. Be able to empty out like the hollow bamboo, then we can.
And that's like your tattoo.
Yeah. The hollow bamboo is, you know, really what I teach, that we have this hollow bamboo as our vessel within us. And so as we empty out, we are then empty and available to receive this new energy, this creative life force that naturally wants to move through. And when we create the space and let go, then we.
Yeah, and it's so amazing. I feel so many parallels in, like, your focus is with the body, and then I use art and business and things like that. But it's the same energy where I think for all of us, we're tuning into, like, what is most important to us? What's our yes? What is our higher self wanting to be on earth? And then how are we going to make that reality? So there's an embodiment component. There's the ability to have a spiritual practice to work whatever muscles are needed for that and then make it real, create it. Yeah.
And which comes from that place of power, like really empowering ourselves, believing in ourselves, and knowing that, you know, this is who we were born to be, and that it's time to say yes and to step into that.
Totally. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yeah. So good. Well, I feel like we could continue.
Yeah, we could go on. Yeah, for sure.
But thank you so much. Thank you for listening and hearing the pool and being here in Costa Rica and having this connection and swimming in the ocean like mermaids.